What's going on? It's your man, Jump Off Joe Beezy. Make sure you tune in to me later this morning with the number one morning show, Ramiro and Pebbles Live, Jamming 94.5.
J'ai le jeu, Michigan. Translation, cause I got game, bitches.
It's Ramiro the freaking Puerto Rican and Pebbles.
Ramiro and Pebbles.
On JAMN 94.5.
Joe Budden, that's a song with the game right there. He's in the studio. What's up, man?
Good morning.
We were just discussing.
Having an argument over here.
Yeah, he was arguing. Oh, comes in here for 30 seconds. I already Melissa's arguing with him about football.
Yeah, how do you treat a guest?
How you gonna treat a guest like that? Right away, she gets mad at you already.
He's talking to me. No, this is the exact quote.
Oh no,
he
don't
says.
Tell the rest of the air. No. Don't tell the boss.
Listen, that's okay. He's a Giants fan, so that's we already have to know that.
And a Yankees fan.
See?
And a nickname.
And thank you for coming in. So,
I probably should have waited until the exit to let you guys know that.
I'll give you the Giants and the Yankees. You're actually a Knicks fan? There's Knicks fans out there?
Yeah.
I figured that they'd all become fans like in 2010 when you guys got LeBron or something like that.
No, you
got
to be. You got to stick it through. See? Good and bad. Gotta stay.
I've
been a Knicks fan since Bernard King, the 80s.
Oh, man.
Yeah, no, his exact quote to me was, "The Patriots are going to suck for a while." And that's where we got into the argument.
That's what Wilson got
Is that
mad.
What I said?
Yes.
I did say that.
Pretty much. Yeah.
I did say that.
He said, but you know what? He was saying kind of what I was saying. I said, you know, get Matt Castle, let Tom Brady and Matt Castle fight it out in training camp because Brady's coming off a major injury.
Major injury.
And we're not seeing any pictures of him. I've been complaining about this since day one. Every time we see a picture of him, he's hanging out with his chick in Mexico instead of being in training with a playbook in his hand.
You guys are so excited about him and you support him so much. He lost y'all the Super Bowl.
He didn't lose the Super
You're
Bowl.
You're killing me right now.
The defense lost the Super Bowl.
Yeah, are you kidding? And his offensive line lost that
Tom
Super Bowl.
Brady
and he's
like
saying
ish.
Trade him. He's like, get rid of him
get
now.
Rid of
you
him.
Can get
I'm about to trade him. Y'all are the kings of trading people who are successful. Trade him. Get him out of here.
Damn.
You got Eli Manning. What are you bragging about? You can't brag about quarterbacks.
We got a Super Bowl. Eli Manning won a Super Bowl.
And he's we got three.
And he's going to win another one. And he's going to win another one.
I bet you the Patriots will win the Super Bowl before the Giants again.
Oh, you're crazy. You're crazy.
Let's throw something down on that.
If Plaxico don't shoot himself in the leg, we'll win the Super Bowl this year. We definitely win the Super Bowl this year.
You can't even keep your athletes in check. What about A-Rod coming out talking about the roids?
Ooh. Hey, A-Rod's the man.
Don't talk bad about A-Rod. A-Roid?
A-Roid, A-Fraud, whatever you want to call it, the best. When it all said and done, he will be the best baseball player to ever pick up a bat.
Yeah, but it's going to be all his everything's going to be tainted. His whole record now, his whole legacy is going to be tainted.
Says you.
Says everybody.
Says you.
Hold on a second.
I disagree.
The people in New York actually support him?
I know I do.
Yeah?
I do. I mean, yeah, look at it. The guy took steroids or he took a banned substance.
Steroids. What he took was like what bodybuilders take.
He took a banned substance in 2003.
2001, 2002, 2003, and that's when he got caught.
2003, wasn't even, he was good back then. He was. He was. But I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt. I don't think he's taking this team. I don't.
Oh, man, he's such a fan.
If it was David
and
Ortiz.
And his name was supposed to be
hand.
On that private list. David Ortiz fell off.
Oh, damn.
No?
He did fall off.
I agree.
Last
okay.
Year,
that always happens. David Ortiz fell off. You took Manny off the team, trying to do the Boston correct right thing, and the team is.
But at least David Ortiz didn't take steroids. He's just fat.
Oh, my God.
David Ortiz.
This is just getting really, really bad.
Hey, I want to just say
nice.
I love Boston.
Yeah,
and
we
I have
tell.
No beef with Boston teams.
Man.
What about our Celtics? You're a Knicks fan, so.
Oh, my God. Are you serious? We're going to talk about the Celtics?
Yes.
Why?
NBA champs?
Why not?
I'd win a champ, too. The chip, too, if I spent $100 and whatever million in one summer.
Seriously.
The Yankees have been doing that for years.
I know, but still.
So you can't fault us for that.
You know what's funny? Boston Garden was so empty, though. I love you guys. You guys are so fickle.
I keep it real. I am fickle.
The Celtics,
I've said it a million times. My thing is, if you keep my interest, there's so much going on in the world that I don't have. If a team sucks, I'm not that much of a fan that I'm gonna be like, yo, I'm gonna go watch that team lose. I want to see them win. So if you're sucking right now, then call me back when you're winning. You know what I mean? Like if you have a girl and she used to look mad good, right? Mm-hmm. And also she starts gaining weight. What do you say to her? Calm when you hit the gym again.
Oh, that's
calm when you lose some pounds.
That's horrible.
It's true. Because you know she had the potential to be good looking. Like, she was always big. That's different.
Or you don't say anything. But if you just drop off in front of the gym.
Oh, my God.
Just give her a subtle hint.
Just send her a pamphlet.
And thank you for coming in.
And for Christmas. Here's a gift card. Here's 24 months of the gym free. Yeah, courtesy of me.
It's all good. So Joe got a... you're on a record label in Boston? Amalgam Digital?
Oh, snap. You said that correctly.
Oh yeah, don't thank this one right here behind me, Pup Dog. He goes, yo, he's on a record label in Boston. I go, what's it called? He goes, what did you say?
Amalgam.
Amigail. And I said, what? He goes, Amigail.
I've heard that one.
What the hell is Amigail? What the hell kind of name of a record label is that? I go, let me look at that card, you illiterate dumb son of a bitch. It's Amalgam.
Yeah, you're pretty good.
You're pretty good.
I'm impressed.
I'm surprised my people can't read, dude. Seriously.
You're too busy watching Celtics games. Red Sox games.
So you're on, it's Amalgam Digital.
Amalgam Digital, Boston based. See? Told you I love Boston.
Yeah, seriously. And
it's not our sports teams.
Right.
The album is Padded Room.
Padded Room.
That's coming out February 24th.
February 24th. Yes.
So you got the game on there. Who else is on there?
Me.
Just you?
Just me. And it's incredible.
It's just you by yourself? That's huge these days.
It's good.
Yeah.
Nobody does like solo albums anymore.
That's because they can't rap.
Really?
that's why. They can't rap, so they hide it with a bunch of features.
You're the only guy who can rap?
Kind of like Boston. They couldn't play ball, so they went out and got a bunch of people to cook.
They won us championships.
It did work. It did work.
Yeah. It didn't work for the Yankees, though. They've been buying dudes for years now. They still haven't won anything.
Oh, my God. What are you talking about, Boston? They'll win it this year. Say something. Say something. Say something. Say something.
That's what you guys have been saying since 2001.
We'll win it this year, though. And if we don't, somebody's going to be in big trouble.
I don't know, man. That's a lot of egos.
Boston won't win it, though. You guys really that big on Jason Bam?
I'd rather have Manny. You kidding me?
Yeah,
I was heated when they got rid of him.
Hey, you know what? I respect your honesty.
I was like, who cares about his attitude? I just care about the dude hitting freaking home runs. I can give a rat's ass what he does. Yeah.
Basically.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm mad that the Mets aren't picking him up right now.
You know what? Nobody's. That's how bad his attitude is.
Is he going to go back to the Dodgers? Probably?
Back to the Dodgers.
Yeah. Back to the Dodgers.
Yeah.
They're not giving him what he wants. He's got a bad attitude.
Well, he's 37. He wants 4 years. Nobody's going to give it to him.
Right, right.
Exactly.
So did you watch the Grammys on Sunday night?
Not at all.
Do you ever watch the Grammys or are you not into award
shows? No. I watch it. It kind of crept up on me this year.
Yeah.
Like I only planned for it, maybe cook or something. And I sit there and I hate on everybody. But not this year.
What if you got invited to it? Would you go? If you got invited to the Grammys?
I went. When I was nominated, I went, and I was really excited. Brought my mom, got a nice little outfit. Mm-hmm. It was the most boring thing in the world.
Oh, really?
It was definitely boring. Definitely, definitely boring. But if you're nominated, of course you go.
Yeah.
So if I was nominated, I would go.
Did they put the camera on you when they said you know, nominations for whatever?
I wouldn't know. And if they did, I was probably looking uncomfortable.
Because I want to know, like, wait,
what is when we watch?
Yeah, because I just want to know what face you make if you like when you don't win, and like, do you go like, damn? Or do you have to play like, yeah,
you gotta play
congratulations.
Cool. You got to play nice and pretend like you're happy for whoever won.
No, you need to mouth. You need to mouth BS.
Exactly.
Did you have a speech prepared in case you had won?
Did I? No, I did not. I knew I wasn't going to win.
Well, who were you up against when you won?
I was up against all of the greatest rappers to ever do it. Joe Budden, Jay-Z, Eminem, 50 Cent.
They're going around everybody. They said Joe Budden put the camera on the wrong guy.
Yeah.
I'm over here, idiot.
I thought I was nominated by mistake.
Oh, God.
That's hilarious, man. All right, so let's take a little break. I want to come back with Joe Budden. I want to ask you about beef. With Saigon, that's who you had beef with, right?
Jesus, Mary, Joseph.
Yeah, we got to ask you about that. And I also got to ask you about Chris Brown.
Oh, great.
Rihanna, Chris Brown. I got to ask everyone's opinion on that.
Chris Brown, Thug of the Year.
Damn.
Yo, seriously.
And it's only February.
We'll be right back. Hang on.